besar esta noche. Serás mi esta noche. Good morning, Flyers. Welcome back to the Early Bird. I'm your host, Griffin Yarmaloff, and alongside me, as always, is the man, Mr. Shea Curry.
What's up, Flyers? And Griffin, man, how was your
break? Yeah.
It was great, bro. I mean, February break felt great. Took a week off to, like, relax, you know, came back. It's still February for some reason. But, yeah, I got a lot done. I was very productive. I got a lot of missing assignments I had to do. Did a lot of reading. I did, like, a lot of studying. What did you do over break?
Oh, man. I slept.
Makes sense. Hair looks like it. We have an amazing episode for you today. We have another Monday movie rant coming up, but first, the introduction. Sorry about that, folks. We had a bit of an audio problem. Hey, but now we are back with a Monday movie rant. So, last night was the SAG Awards, the Screen Actors Guild Awards. Basically, these are like the Oscars, but more prestigious for the actors themselves. So, these awards are going to be good indicators on which actors are going to go on to win Oscars in a few weeks from now, in March 27th. So, let's start with Best Actor with the blowout from Will Smith again. His performance as King Richard was absolutely phenomenal, and no one else should win this award, although shout out Andrew Garfield. Best Actress was a little controversial as it went to Jessica Chastain for The Eyes of Tammy Faye instead of Nicole Kidman for Being the Ricardos, or Kristen Stewart for Spencer, who wasn't even nominated after winning the Golden Globes, which is very suspicious. It'll be very interesting to see who will win that award during the Oscar season. Now moving on to Best Actor, Best Supporting Actor, Cody Schmidt-McPhee lost to Troy Koster from Coda. Very interesting choice by this group of award selectors. I think Cody Schmidt-McPhee will go on to win in a few weeks from now because of his amazing performance in The Power of the Dog. But Coda is going to have a strong showing at the Academy Awards. And then Best Supporting Actress went to Ariana DeBose for her role in West Side Story. Hands down, Best Supporting Actress of the year. Wouldn't give it to anyone else. Finally, the Best Ensemble Cast went to Coda. So congratulations to them. Next, I want to talk about Megalopolis by Francis Ford Coppola. Francis Ford Coppola, the director of Apocalypse Now, all the Godfather movies. He's a legendary director. He has fallen off with not being as successful as he wants, but he just poured $120 million of his own money into this new secret project called Megalopolis. No one knows what it is, but he's directing it, and there's secret actors and the whole secret crew working on it. It's going to be really cool to see what that turns into in a few years, as it will be his retirement movie. So the legend can make one more movie, Megalopolis. We can see what that turns into. Finally, for an actual movie review, Uncharted, official review. Trash. That's all for today's movie rant. And now live in the studio with the pledge is Ben.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
That's all for today's episode of The Early Bird. If you enjoyed this episode and you want to watch it again, you can find it on our YouTube or on our Instagram bio at Framing High Studios. Shay, man, what does The Early Bird get?
Uncharted was so good.
Okay.
I don't know what he's saying.
I disagree. I think Uncharted was bad. He thinks it was good. We talked together. The Early Bird?
Uncharted was good.
The Early Bird gets the worm!
It's
Unaos. Hay un rayo de luz que entró por mi...